In Matthew chapter 19, verses 5 and 6, Jesus says, "For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother, be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So then they're no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no man separate." We're here today to celebrate two people, Justin and Katrina, and it's such a special day. But marriage is not to be entered lightly, because we just read, as God's word said, it involves God joining two people. And really, this means a covenant is being taken place. It's being taken place between Justin and Katrina and before God. And so this is such a beautiful day, but it's with this in mind that I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man? If you would, go ahead and pass it off. If you would bow your head with me, we're going to take a moment and pray. Father, we thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for bringing Justin and Katrina together. Lord, thank you for friends and family members that are here today to celebrate this special moment. Lord, I pray that this would bring honor and glory to you. Lord, we thank you for the gift of marriage. Lord, we love you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Justin, Katrina, take a deep breath. You are finally here. We made it. Look around at your family and your friends. Such an exciting day. One of the passages that we've talked about, Psalm chapter 127, verse 1, it says this. It says, "Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain who build it." God has given us the gift of marriage. It is like a house. And it is not going to be built properly. It's not going to stand properly unless the Lord is in it. So we need the Lord to build this house. Now, both of you profess to be Christians. You profess to know Jesus Christ. And you understand that Christian faith must be the foundation of your marriage. And with this in mind, I want to read a few passages from the Bible. In Genesis 1 and 2, we discover that God is the creator of everything, but he's also the creator of marriage. He's the originator of it. It was his idea. After creating Adam, God said in Genesis 2:18, "It is not good that man should be alone." Justin, I think you would agree with me. It's not good for you to be alone. You're better when Katrina is around. In verse 24, God says, "Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." This is the joining that God does in marriage. It's a covenant that two people make before each other, before God. And I want to read another passage. It's found in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22 through 33. Listen to what God's word says. "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as also Christ is head of the church. And he's the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body and of his flesh and of his bones. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband." In this passage, God teaches us that marriage is to be a picture. It's to be a picture of Christ's love for his people. And this requires selfless and sacrificial love. Katrina, your role in marriage is to be that of the church, as the church loves Christ and submits themselves to Christ and selflessly and sacrificially loves Christ. That's your role. That's the picture that you are to give to everyone. Justin, your role seems to be a bit more challenging, because as we just read, you are to love Katrina with the same love that Christ loved us with. We know that Christ laid down his life. He went to the cross for us. It's the kind of love that you're called to love Katrina. It's agape love. It's unconditional. It's not based on how Katrina treats you. It's you making a choice to love Katrina. Katrina, Justin's got it going on right now. Look at him. He's all cleaned up and sharp. You did that too. That's good. You may have to do it here on after as well. But here's the reality. Justin, he's looking good, but there's going to be days where he makes mistakes. And you know that. And in those hard days, you're going to have to make a choice to love. Again, it's the agape love that we see in the Bible. That word agape, meaning unconditional. It's where you make a choice to love. And Justin, Katrina looks beautiful today, doesn't she? There's going to be many days where Katrina, she's going to disappoint you. There's going to be some things that she says that upsets you. Maybe some things that she does that disappoints you. You're going to have to make a choice to love her. You're going to have to love her with that same agape love, that unconditional love. And as both of you unconditionally love one another, you're going to give a picture to the world that we just read. A picture of Christ loving people. It's going to be a picture to everybody else, but it's also going to benefit both of you as you love and support each other. And so this choice to love one another is based on the covenant that you're making today. And so as people see your love for one another, may it reflect Jesus' covenant love for the church. So at this time, if you would, I want you to hold hands. And we're going to begin with you. And Justin, I'm going to read several statements. And if you vow to keep these, if you would respond by saying, I do. Justin, do you take Katrina to be your wife? Do you agree to enter into God's covenant of marriage with her? Do you agree to love Katrina through life's failures and successes? Do you covenant to serve Katrina and comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And do you agree to forsake all others and keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live? Katrina, do you take Justin to be your husband? Do you agree to enter into God's covenant of marriage with him? Do you agree to love Justin through life's failures and successes? Do you covenant to serve Justin and comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health? And do you agree to forsake all others and keep yourself only for him as long as you both shall live? Justin, if you would, repeat after me. I, Justin, take you, Katrina. To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Katrina, if you would repeat after me. I, Katrina, take you, Justin.
I, Katrina, take you, Justin.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold. From this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Justin and Katrina have chosen their ring to represent a token of their vows. This ring is an outward symbol of the covenant that is being made today. This ring demonstrates the unashamed commitment to one another. May we have the rings? Justin, if you would take one ring and Katrina the other. All right, Justin, we'll begin with you. As you place this ring on Katrina's finger, if you would repeat after me. With this ring, I enter into a covenant with you. And everything that I possess, I now give to you. I pledge my love to you forever. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Katrina, if you would, take the ring and place it on Justin's finger. And as you do this, repeat after me.
With this ring,
I enter into a covenant with you. And everything that I possess, I now give to you. I pledge my love to you forever. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. At this time, Justin and Katrina will illustrate the covenant of marriage by way of the unity cross and the lighting of the unity candle. The cross is important for both Justin and Katrina. The Bible teaches that on the cross, Jesus took the punishment for our sin. Romans 3:23, it states that all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23 says, for the wages, or the payment of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Romans 5:8 says, God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were sinners, Christ died for us. Through Jesus' death on the cross, we can experience forgiveness, life, and salvation. And God's word says, whosoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Salvation is not based on the good works that we do for God. It is based on the good works that Jesus has done for us. Salvation is as simple as turning from your sin and trusting in Jesus Christ. If you desire to be saved and forgiven of your sin in this way, simply express this in a prayer to God, asking for forgiveness and salvation. Unity Cross, it is composed of multiple parts. The base represents the godly foundation that Justin and Katrina desire to build their marriage on. The outer portion of the cross represents strength, leadership, and protection from the man. Justin, that's your role. The inner portion of the cross represents the intricate beauty and many capabilities of the woman. Three pegs hold these two pieces together. These pegs represent the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit showing God's place in this covenant and the security and completeness that only our Heavenly Father can give. And so, as Justin and Katrina assemble this cross, I ask that each of us evaluate our hearts and that we ask the question, have I looked to the cross? Is the cross my foundation? Have I experienced foundation? Pray with me. Father, we thank you so much for what you have done today. Thank you for this covenant that has been made. I pray that you would bless Justin and Katrina. Pray that you would watch over them, give them the strength each and every day to follow you, to love one another. I pray that their marriage would be the picture that we have discussed this evening, the picture of your love for us. We love you, and it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
When God is joined together, let no man tear apart. Based upon your decision to enter into the marriage covenant through the exchanging of the vows and the giving of the rings, I celebrate with you, by virtue of the authority invested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, in the presence of God and these witnesses, I pronounce you husband and wife. Yeah. Justin, you may kiss your bride. It is now my privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Justin Gilbert.
Woo-hoo!
The music.